Hello everyone, welcome to another week in this episode of Everything Startup with Timmy the Law. Today I'll be discussing an important subject, which is the business plan. You would remember that the whole episode is built around trying to help startups, upstarts, ideators, innovators, those with talents, develop some level of foundation. And so we'll be discussing the business plan. However, the best business plan ever written was written on a tissue paper. However, that doesn't mean that business plan do not count. Now, let me give you some facts. Out of every business in the next, over a period of 5 years, only 10% of every business over a period of 5 years outlasts that period. Now, out of that 10%, only 1% survive beyond 5 years. And this survival has been attributed largely and partly to a clear-cut, pragmatic business plan. And so, a business plan is key, but not for everyone. The business plan would help, just like a plan, would help you set the objectives, the priorities, and the cash flow for the business. Like a very established entrepreneur rightly stated, as a business person, never go into a business if you are still thinking of survival. In other words, you must have a cash flow. And so the business plan helps you to clarify these key issues. Now, you could need a business plan when you need to start securing external sources of finance. For example, loans. For example, investments. You would need a clear business plan. In fact, I advise clients, as a tech IP lawyer, I advise clients that, look, do not invest in any business, no matter how small the business is, that doesn't have a business plan, because an investment contract must come with a clear-cut roadmap, which is a business plan. And therefore, the business plan helps to predict trends and key points, thereby mapping key areas of concern, of strength, and helps the business to focus. Look, unlike concept notes, the business plan is more elaborate, as the research into a business plan must both be qualitative and quantitative. By that I mean that it is not just about getting to understand the clients in a business plan. You must also understand your numbers, without which you cannot properly run a successful and sustainable business. A lot of people do copy and paste when it comes to business plan. My advice is simple. Start with the concept notes, and then as the business unfolds, you can graduate furthermore into a pragmatic, practical business plan, stating the price, the delivery, and the market strategy involved. This is Timmy Olagunju on Everything Startup with Timmy the Law. You can follow our handles and also send questions to our handles on your screen. Thank you.